Hey kids, welcome back to another lesson. I hope you're excited to learn something new today, and I hope you had an amazing week as well. So before we start, let's bow our heads and close our eyes as we pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for all this time that you helped us, oh Lord, during this time, Lord. We pray that the kids shall learn something new and that they shall use it, oh Lord, for their talents, oh Lord. They shall use it in the real life world, Lord. And we thank you for all the times that you've helped us and guided us, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Alright, so our title for today's lesson is Praying and Obeying. And our hero for today is Ananias. So, throughout the Bible, God established a wonderful pattern of choosing the most unlikely people to carry out his plan. God chose Saul, a zealous Jew, trying to destroy the early believers, as his instrument to bring the gospel to Gentiles. On the road to Damascus, a great light struck Saul, blinding him. Jesus himself spoke to Saul, admonishing him and giving him instructions. God also used a disciple in Damascus named Ananias. In a vision, God told him to go to a certain house and find Saul. Ananias obeyed. Despite his fear of Saul's antagonistic reputation, God restored Saul's sight and prayed. In this lesson, we're going to learn about how God always answers our prayers, sometimes even with a miracle. We will be encouraged today and we'll listen to God as we pray. Amen. So now it's time to listen to the memory verse, and I'll hand it over to Adit.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5:16-17. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing.
And now it's time to move on to the Bible story for today.
The early church, filled with God's grace, was so perfectly united in their love for God and for others that many Christians sold their land and possessions and distributed the money to those in need. But the power and unity that the early church enjoyed was challenged when Satan himself whispered in the ears of Ananias and Sapphira. Ananias said to his wife, "Let us sell our property, but instead of giving all the money we earn, we will secretly keep some of it ourselves." His wife agreed to the plan. Ananias was eager to lay his portion of money at the feet of the apostles. True, it was not everything he and his wife had earned from the sale, but it was a lot. He felt confident that it was enough to fool everyone into believing his lie, so he could walk away with the honor of men, and all without having to make the ultimate sacrifice of giving it all. But the Spirit of God revealed to the Apostle Peter how Ananias and Sapphira had conspired to lie about how much they were giving to the church. Peter confronted Ananias. "This land belonged to you, and the money you made from the sale belonged to you. Why didn't you just tell us the truth? Instead of leading us to believe that you had given us everything, you have not lied to men, but to God." As soon as he heard those words from Peter, Ananias dropped to the ground and died instantly. The shocking news of the event spread quickly, and all those who heard it were filled with great fear. A couple of young men nearby wrapped up the body and took it outside the city to be buried. This sad story does not end with the death of Ananias. About 3 hours later, his wife Sapphira, unaware of what had happened, came before Peter. No doubt she was filled with pride about what she and her husband were presenting as a great and generous sacrifice. Peter asked her, "Tell me, is this amount the price you and Ananias received for the land you sold?" She replied, "Yes, that is the price." Peter said to her, "How could you conspire to test the Holy Spirit and lie about the money? The same men who buried your husband have returned and will now bury you." As soon as she heard these words from Peter, she fell down at his feet and immediately died, just like her husband. The same young men who had just returned from burying Ananias took her body and buried her alongside her husband. And great fear seized the whole church, as well as everyone else who had heard about the tragic events.
And that's the end of today's lesson. Who are you?
I'm you.
That's not right.
I'm
Well, it is, and I'm here to finish the lesson, so. Okay, well, see kids,
go ahead.
Make prayer an absolute priority in order to live a life that fulfills God's plan for you. He brings you to places that you thought you couldn't even reach. How about that?
Okay, well, now it's time to close it.
Nope.
Oh, you want to pray?
I'll end the prayer.
Thank you
very much.
Sure.
All right. Lord Jesus, we thank you for this time, O Lord, a real life, O Father. We appreciate all you've done for us. We give you all the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. All right, well, now it's time to go on to the play.
Bye.
Decide Pole!
Hey Dee, you remember that time when someone else took your doll?
Oh yeah. You want to tell the kids about it?
Yeah.
Sure. I'll play myself, and Dee, you can play yourself. And Sai, you can be Joey, and my dad.
Wow, that's cool. I can play two people.
Why don't you just go outside, Joey?
No!
Yeah, Joey, go home. You're mean.
Oh, hi, son. Hi, Dee.
Hey, Dad. That Joey just makes me so mad.
Huh? I forgot that Miss Petrie's grandson was visiting. Why are you mad at him?
Look, Dad, we were trying to be nice to Joey, even though he's a pest. We invited him to play in the treehouse with us.
But he didn't play very nicely. My doll is all dirty because of him.
Yeah. Joey took our toys and threw them out of the treehouse. My new military mic is broken. I was so mad that I told Joey to go home.
Sounds like you have a problem that you may need to talk to God about. Maybe you should pray for Joey. Maybe perhaps he's just unhappy about something because he doesn't have any toys here. You could pray that God would bless him with a new toy.
But he just broke my toy. I should talk to God about a new toy for me, not pray for him.
Well, kids, you know that prayer is more about asking God for stuff. Prayer is the way that we talk to God and he talks to us. If you pray for Joey, that God will show you what to do. Now, how about giving me that military mic and I can see if I can fix it?
Your dad is right, Paul. We should probably pray for Joey.
Dear Jesus, help me be nice to Joey, even when he is mean to us. I'm sorry I got so mad at him. Show me what you want me to do.
Dear Jesus, I'm sorry too. Please help us to be kind to Joey. And please bless him with a new toy. In Jesus' name we pray.
Oof, I sure feel better. And I just got an idea.
What is it?
I have $5 in my bank. Let's see if Dad will take us to the store and we'll buy a present for Joey.
That's a great idea. I have $3 at home. I bet we could buy him his own action figure.
Buy who an action figure?
Well, Dad, Dee and I want to put our money together and buy Joey a new toy. Will you take us to the store?
Sure, that's great, but what happened just 5 minutes ago? You were mad at Joey.
Well, when we talked to God in our prayer, he showed us what to do and just do what you said.
Yeah, I knew he would. And Paul, here's your military mic, just as good as new.
Thanks!
Hey kids, I bet sometimes you have problems that you need to talk to God about, am I right?
Yeah, we all have problems that we need to talk to God about. That's why he needs us to pray to him.
That's right. Praying is how we talk to God and how he talks to us. He doesn't speak out loud like we usually do, but he speaks to our hearts. So be sure to pray.
Bye.
Bye.